Well, we're starting our recording now. This is stream, the Vermillion River. It's a small stream that goes through Hastings, Minnesota. Comes down, has a big waterfall. This is below the waterfall, looking east. And so I'll be placing in the upper left, I'll be placing a photo of that I'm taking it from. It's storming outside, so you might hear some storm, thunder and lightning. Thunder for sure you'll be able to hear. So we're gonna start to do this. I penciled in the tree in here and the general location of the cliff on the left and some of the stones that I didn't do too much otherwise. So let's just kind of put it in here. I'm going to kind of put some of this in. And we're just going to rough it in briefly here. Okay, so this is just a bunch of white and it's mixed up a kind of a gray rockish color. Which is burnt umber, some yellow, a little bit of ultramarine blue, and a lot of white, so on. So we'll just put in some of this here. I think I should have some terps to just kind of put it in a little bit more easier here. So just do that. And this is mostly in here, just kind of a bunch of bushes and so on off the cliff that are growing off the I'm going to put a darkish color in there. It's a purple made up of a little bit of burnt umber, some ultramarine blue, alizarin crimson, and that's what I have mixed up here. And we'll just kind of just put it in here. Arbitrarily and pretty quickly. Let's see. So it's where some of the darks are. I'm just gonna put in some of these darks in here with this same color. This is a light purple, so it's not gonna bother anything if I change color later. It's not gonna be so obtrusive that it's gonna to ruin all of the mixtures. So this is just kind of play for placement here. So just arbitrarily just doing it pretty quickly. I'm going to brush in some of the water down here real quickly. Now, water is not always blue. It's going to be a result of reflection. Reflection from everything else. So this is, I'm using the same color that I've used up here. I'll mix it, I'm mixing it just with a trifle, a little bit of green for some of these mixtures in here. Adding a little bit of terps again. And doing a horizontal stroke in here just to fill it in a little bit. All right, so we'll take another mixture. This is Ultramarine Blue, burnt umber, and it's darker. And I'm just going to flick in briefly some of that tree. The tree on the right here. I don't really care too much about it, just want to make sure it's there. And just kind of draw this in just temporarily. All right, so we're just kind of adjusting where we're seeing some of these things. This is going to be a dark that's going to be showing up here because it's sort of at the this here's my focal point right in here. It. I'm just going to now I believe what I should do is I'm going to scumble in this area of greens right here. Very light greens, light green. It's low keyed and I'm going to just scumble them in here. It looks appears that like that goes all the way up here across these branches. It's behind the branches, of course, but so it's a little bit darker value than I actually have. They're going to be a little bit lighter here, a little bit darker here. Greens here as well. And then a little bit lighter here. This is a much yellower green down here, and then mix that up a little bit, add a little bit more white. Just get this so far away, but normally the closer the item, you know, if it's the same item we're talking about. Normally it's going to be yellow, more of a yellower tone closer to you, but in this instance, this is how it is in this in this location, so I'm going to do it that way. Okay, and let's see. How is this zooming? I've got to, there we go. It zoomed out, so I didn't know how to. Okay, so I'm going to add a little bit darker greenish color here. This is just has a little bit more ultramarine blue in it. Actually, this is cerulean blue, excuse me. So I'm putting that in here. And a little bit of terps here to kind of pull this in here. Just more bluer green. Add a little bit more ultramarine blue to this mixture. And we're going to just use the terps and just put this in a little bit more heavier right here. Trying to do this painting a little bit quicker. This is a panel that I made. It's the same, if you look on my, it's made in the same way as my panels. I've got, hopefully I'll put up a tab stating or showing or referencing, excuse me, a linking to a video I did showing how to make panels from an applying canvas to panels. That might be helpful. This down here, I'm just going to put that in the general tone here. Middle tone, which is lighter than the stream itself, but as you can see, it's not much lighter, so that, but it will be in a little bit. Okay, I'm going to apply some of that, the darks that we used up here with some of the green mixtures. And I'm going to put those down here. Some of these are showing, like right here, that's a shadow, cast shadow from some branch or whatever. This is like a cast shadow from this tree, I believe. Kind of hard to tell right now. It has a greenish blue-green look to it. So I'm going to add a little bit of blue and a little bit of green here. And just put it in there. I want to get rid of all the white here, the canvas. toss in a little bit of yellow mixture, yellow mixture in here. This is a reflection from these up above. A little bit of cadmium yellow there, mixed with a lot of gray. And just include, there's a little touch of bluish, wonderful blue from this water reflection also off of the this area of the rock. I'm going to put some of this gray that we mixed up earlier. Kind of fun to do these kind of paintings. They're not hard, by the way. Sometimes this kind of stuff intimidates people. With all these trees and bushes and water and everything else. I'm just going to put this in here temporarily. Just to show me where this little wave is in here, just do a for placement, and put this in here for placement as well. Okay, I'm gonna throw a little bit of some more greens up here. More thicker greens, thicker paint, that is. This is a little bit darker than these around here. So we're just going to put some of this in here. Very light yellow greens right here. Let's put in a few more darks right in here, just to stabilize and the brush over here. Put in a couple accent colors right here. Just to show accents, just to stabilize this couple elements here. It's a crack and slit in the rock and so on. I didn't even put my apron on. I should have my apron. Oh well. Most important thing is to get your values right. If you get the darks and the lights right, the darkness and the light relative to each other, you're actually doing and accomplishing something then. Some of these darks, when I make them and so on, they seem to be lighter. You know, how do I do it with one brush stroke? Because it's how hard I'm pressing on the brush. The more you paint, the better you get at it. Mix up another dark here, Ultramarine Blue, Burnt Umber. I'm throwing in a little bit of Alizarin Crimson in here. It's a warm dark, pretty dark though. If you're right here with me, you'd say, oh gee, it almost looks black. Well, I have black on my palette, but I don't hardly ever use it. The only time I use it is when necessary, and it's necessary very few times. But when you need it, you need it. So this is sort of some calligraphy you kind of do. This is the shadow side of the different rocks and so on. There. You can see some of these rocks come to life. You think, how's that done? Well, I'm just looking at the shadow side of the rocks. And I'm just putting that in. Don't want to overdo this thing, though. this is some darks that are showing through all of these leaves. We'll worry about those later. I'm going to put in that very light rockway in the end. At the end here. You can't really see it because it's on this white canvas, so I'll get rid of that real quickly. We're going to put a dark down there. Okay, here we are again. I'm adding a cerulean blue mixture, light mixture right here in these darks here. What I'll do is probably come back again to reinstate that, because right now all this wet paint on there is not covering that well. And that's okay for right now. You don't want to intensify colors too much on the painting. I used to do it all the time when it's we're first starting out, and it always looks too garish. You have to really watch out for that. Up here we've got some yellows. We gotta start putting in some yellows up there and so on. I think what we have here is I have to come and start doing some blue. And I'm going to mix it with a lot of this white yellowish mixture, which is a kind of a compliment. So we'll do that. And we'll put that in. So as it comes lower and so on, it gets lighter. So it's mixing a little bit with these blacks. I gotta watch out for that. Maybe shouldn't have done that right now, but that's okay. This is a yellowish white mixture with some cerulean blue. And it's also got some of that greens that I just splashed on there a little bit ago. And this is to cover the canvas. You don't want to get carried away with anything right now. I'm hardly touching those darks. I don't want that to plague my painting at all. Okay. So what do we have when we get back a little bit? We got something that has some potential. So that's good. Let's add some lighter lights to some of these rocks. This is not a too light of a mixture now. It's just lighter than what's there. Sometimes you want to group rocks together. Okay, you can see how rocks are starting to appear. We don't want to overdo them right at the moment. Okay, for right now, we're just going to leave them go and define them later. Going to look up here a little bit and define some of this. We've got a bush here. We'll be putting that in later. Just kind of, you gotta feel these rocks out. Always noting that, you know, some places it's gonna be darker than others. This rock has more of a horizontal bent, all pointing. So you gotta remember that they're all pointing down to the horizon pretty much, so. You put down what appears to look like rock. And as something appears to look like rock more than you thought it would, then that you play, you go along with it. If it works for you. Okay, right in here we've got this darker tree. It is a yellowish green tree. So let's put that in more so as it appears. Kind of pushing up with my brush a little bit. It appears to be a lot lighter though, right? Well, actually, it is about this dark, but it's a little bit more intense. So let's add a little bit of cadmium yellow to it, a little bit of white. See if that helps a little. This is a grouping of a number of trees, actually. So, let me get another brush here. And I'm going to put in, I want to put in some of that very light blue in the background. So you can place that right now. It's very, very light. And I'll pull that lightness up here as well. Up in this area. I'm using a thicker paint. I'm actually putting some white down there because it's not getting lighter. So I'm going to apply a little bit heavier pigment. Getting a new paper towel. This one, of course, because I've getting this lighter in the background, this is getting darker, as you can see. And this is very light yellow right in there. So I'm going to add some white to that yellow. You can see that I can't make this tube my light, or this won't show up. This is showing up light because of this being a little bit darker. I'm going to add a little bit more yellow to this, right in this area. There's a few lighter strokes in here. more green in this area. Don't want to get it too dark. We're working on this painting here. And I'm going to jump down here right at the moment, put some a little bit lighter cerulean blue here. See, there's a rock right here. Yeah, just put him in there. Another kind of rock here. I'm gonna add a few lights here. These rocks. Add some more yellows right in here. This reflection is really strong. The only way to do it is to actually add some more texture as well. It's got to be thicker paint. And this is more of a bluer. Kind of a cast bluer shadow toward the inside. So looks like there's some rocks way in the background here. Like a lighter rock right here. I'm gonna put in a dab of white there. I mean, not white, but this off yellow white gray mixture. And then there's some purples, so I'm gonna add a little bit of purple in here. Slight purples. There's a little bit of purple foliage coming down here. Okay, let's look at this tree and get this tree in there a little bit better. Appears like there's a couple trees giving us some problems here. adding a little bit of purple around the branches here. It's actually mini branches, kind of gives this darkest haze to it right there. It's a bunch of brambles and a bunch of there's other little branches and stuff sticking up here, and I'm just going to put those in. But they're not in, you can't see a lot of them. It's hard to see. So you be just as nebulous as nature tends to be. There's a crack way back there. So it's deeper, so you can't see into it, and therefore it's much darker. There's small ledges along here. Here's another branch right here. This has some, there's some brush or some kind of foliage right in here. And it's fact, it's throughout this whole thing. So it's almost like it's obliterating this to some extent. I can see some of it I can't. So we're gonna put in some, I can see some areas of yellow that were, it is kind of allowing us to see. It's very tricky in a lot of ways though, because you know, the brush is distorting a lot of things. So I'm doing the same thing. See, so you have to squint and see what you have there and then put that in. And watch out, you got to watch out. Here's light again, dark against dark here. So I'm going to put in just a few little hints of the foliage in very much lighter tone. And then it reads light against dark. And there's that really nice dark up there. I'll put that in right like that. And this appears like it's partially being hid behind that foliage. So we're gonna leave some of that. Allow some of that to peek out. Between the foliage. I'm now loading up my brush with a lot of paint. And I'm putting some really kind of thick impasto strokes down there. And I'm going to put some impasto strokes up here too. Allowing some of that brush to obliterate that background. You see how effectively it actually works. These are the things that when I first started out, it would just get me. I just couldn't seem to do it. All I realize is all about value. All about value. Now I'm using some downward strokes now because that's how things are growing right there. There's a couple things that coming down here. I'm allowing that to happen. A lot of horizontal strokes up here. Notice sometimes you need those you need some hard edges. Where you have hard edges and you need it, then you gotta put them in. Evidently, this is, you're seeing some of the, yeah, I guess that's the top of the mountain right there, or the cliff, or whatever it is. This area so much looks western. Doesn't it look like it's western scene? But it isn't. It's a Minnesota scene. So it's really amazing a lot of times. Where a certain location will appear like another state, practically. Okay, now there's, this area is actually much bluer, so I'm going to blue it up, and in other words, it's kind of like dug out from the river stream. This has much, you notice that there's a really good dark right there, and I'm allowing it to stay there. Very nicely done. All right. It's kind of a darkish green right in here, low intensity green, and must be moss or something on the bank. So we'll put that in. Some of this is much greener right in here. We'll just put that in like that. Putting see some brighter rocks right in here. I'm going to add some very light gray there, and I'm going to leave those very impostle like strokes right there. We see some here. Allow also very thick brush like strokes. I'm putting it in. Sometimes I like it when you can feel the painting. You can almost feel how thick that paint is. That's beautiful sometimes. So you work back and forth, and what I like to do is like blue these shadow areas up, because they are bluish in a lot of ways. Within the blue, sometimes I'll throw some reds in there, Alizarin Crimson and so on. This blue, for instance, I'll throwing some reds in there. Yeah, starting to look okay. I just put a glob of paint on my brush there and just kind of snuck it along, and the leaves leaving that look. And quite like the original. It's break that up a little bit, and there. Now I kind of like some of this going on around here. Throwing a couple of those in, as though you're seeing the rock behind. I'm putting some texture up here a little bit. With some very impasto-like strokes, as well as up here. See this one crevice up there, it's kind of neat looking, so I'm going to put that in. See some that's pretty close. We're working pretty close to the top. Don't want to do too much up there because part of the frame's going to be taking up a quarter inch. You don't want to get too intrigued with stuff up too far. See, some of these trees are into this area too, so I've got to allow some of this tree to come in here and some of the cliff to come in there, because they're back and forth. I'm going to have to increase the green of some of this stuff here, of the trees, I mean, in order to read against it. Huh? We're just throwing some branches in here. Remember, the branches are a little thinner at the top. So, coming back and making sure that's done. Gotta come in with some almost pure cad yellow, but as I put it on, I'm mixing it. So I make a lot of my colors and so on. I get it from just doing some broken color in there. Sometimes you need to. Okay, so some of that's looking pretty good there. I see some of that cliff right through here, and I want to see a little bit of that kind of coming through. And maybe up here too. But you want to watch it. Don't overdo it. You want it to be pretty nebulous in a lot of ways. We've got this darker bluer green right in here that we want to. What I'm doing now is throwing some broken color into this. What it is two or three different greens, all at the same value, but they're different colors, different color greens. That will make some really nice coloring. And it will work for you. Now going to find find some of these trees again. So we'll put put one in there. Have to be quick at some of this stuff. Oh geez, she's throwing up another air ball. If these, a lot of these trees have personalities in a lot of ways, because they all look so different. You want to know this? Make sure that they look like they're heavier. Heavier at the bottom, all of them will taper. They have bulges in them. They have very unique variables, and you should get those in. It helps. Helps to do that. Okay, there's some bluer trees, a bush back here, especially back here. That's good because it looks like it's further away. Okay, now we're got some of that in there pretty good. Now let's just define some of these rocks in this area a little bit. Notice how dark some of this is. Let's put it in as that. Notice that there's another stick here. I don't know if I want to put that in there. I think it's just screws it up. Too much information there. And so I think I'm not going to do that. Putting in some darks here. Now, typically your darks are laid in light, and thinner. And that's true, typically. But sometimes, when you're doing alla prima, and I pretty much paint alla prima, you're going to have some darks that are actually thick too. But, those darks are ringing pretty nice right now. Maybe I'll put a little stick in there. I don't know. I gotta watch it though. You know, because what are you gonna put on the stick? So, kind of difficult sometimes to know what you want to do. I really highlighted that and putting in some really lights there. I'm going to also throw this blue in there a little bit heavier. Yeah, I think that kind of works. Okay, we're going to define some of these rocks a little bit lighter now. So you want to look at each rock and just kind of define it. Yeah, that makes sense. That rock could be there. You also want to group them. You don't want too many separate rocks looking kind of quirky on you. Them all to be the same value either. So you can see some of these out here that are really out here, you might have just a dark because you're not going to have lights. Light isn't going to hit it. And if you do, I can see some darks here. You know, those rocks are underneath there. You can see those rocks? Well, that light is light enough to be underneath. Okay, so you don't want to overdo this rock here area. This is closer to me. Probably use a few not all rocks could have a really defined shadow. So you know, it might be something like that instead. I'm looking at it, go backing up, and it's tending to look pretty good. I want to put a few accent darks in there too. I'm actually using a little bit of Alizarin Crimson in here as well. Want to watch out for these. Hey, this is kind of a non-defined area, so I better start defining it a little bit. And I'm just putting a few rocks in there. Okay, so this is not really working right here, so I better... Yeah, see, I don't want too much going on here. I want this. This is kind of leading up to it, and it's going over there like that. That kind of works to some extent. This I don't think is working very good. I'm putting a... couple darks in there. Want people to kind of jump from one to another, go back into the picture there. Okay. So we have to start defining this to some extent. Placing this. Practically, cadmium yellow out of the tube. Because it's so light up here, this is not going to really look garish because it's so light. Everything is so light, so I don't have to worry about it so much. See all the throw a bunch more yellows over here. Some cad yellow. And we're just going to push this in here. Okay, as you can see, that had to warm this area up along here. I'm going to cool some of this area down right in this area. Pull some of this. I'm going to allow, there's some yellows around here in the original. I'm going to get rid of those. I'm going to allow this to be pretty cool because it looks like it's further away. Generally. So I think that's a good thing. I think it make sure that, hey, things stay in pretty much in the background. There is actually, I'm throwing a bunch of purples right in here. I see some hints of some brush and so on. And we've got a lot of purple's right in up in this area. Purples and browns. Some browns in this area too. Just kind of put them in there. Okay. I'm going to put a little bit of alizarin crimson. I see some crimson in it. In here, okay, so this side is very nebulous, so we have to, I'm putting it in the same manner as what I'm looking at it. Because this is really up close, and I don't want to get up too, I don't want to get too detailed here because it's too close. There is definitely some blue greens up in here, and I'll put some in. But a lot of yellow greens too. So I'll throw some, especially some yellow into this area. Okay, I'm going to need to mix up a green here that I want. It's right in this green in here should be a little bit in the middle of the yellow green mixture, but it shouldn't be too let's see what this is. Yeah, somewhat. So I'm mixing up another green here, and I'm leaving it very broken, so I'm going to be putting it in here. You can see how it kind of tintillates and jumps, vibrates a little bit. There's some brush over here, a little bit of some foliage over here, kind of creeping in, and do some final changes, and then we'll call it quits. Just add a couple darks along here, a couple reflected lights. There's some greenery in here. Just a little bit. Okay, and then maybe a couple more along here. Some lights. Let's look at that. That stream needs a little bit of work. Darker in here. It appears to be a little bit of almost like I don't have any, and that I mean it's almost like viridian. So I'm going to put a little bit of that in. I made it viridian like mixture from cerulean and see what did they use? I think it was a little of sap green and then some ultramarine blue is what it was. So also it appears like it's going down here, along here, and then down into this area as well. It comes up right here, it hits that those waves and then recedes. So you can almost, there's some burnt umber in there too. I'll put a little bit of burnt umber in there. Okay. Bring in some more whites right in here. And along that area. Yeah, I think that's a little better. There's a little bit of some blues in there too. And it's, I'm going to add some cerulean in there. Appears like there's a bunch here. Yeah. See, this is where the main flow is, and then this is kind of like a backwater sort of area. And so, it has some darks in it. What those darks are rocks and so on in the bottom. It's not very dark. I mean, it's not very deep along here. There's some water action along here. And I can see that. I'm adding from the pile of the purples and some greens that I've found. Some of these grays that I have on my palette, I'm going to pull back in to this area. And then there's some blues as well. Gonna throw that in there. Pick that out right there. And see, there's some rippling of, it appears some rippling. Along here. Because it's hitting some of these rocks here. So we're going to put that in there. It appears now like, yeah, it's hitting some rocks and creating a little bit of splash. It appears like there's a little bit more. I just want to introduce a pretty good little bunch of water in there to thicker. You can see the it appears now a little bit verbose, a little bit higher waves and a little bit more treacherous or treacherous waves right there. I mean, they're not treacherous. It's only two feet deep. But I think that works a little better along here. I see some darks laying down here. And I'm going to put some of those down. There's some darks in here. A little bit of burnt umber along here. Deeper. Who knows exactly what's happening? I think a lot of it is a lot of these lights. There's some lights in here. I'm going to put some lights in here. A lot of these lights, a reflection off of the top cliff area. And I'm going to include some of those cliffs right in there. Some of these dark areas are probably reflection off the crevices on the top. That's what I think they are. That's what I think we're having happen. Some of these lights crisscross, we've got some of this happening. Looking a lot better. I don't have any problems with it really. I think we'll call it that's it for a while. In a little bit, I got to pull this big gob. paint. Big gob of paint. Great big gob. And we'll just allow it to fall and include what we need from it. There we go. Take the big gob away. All right. Yeah. It appears to be pretty acceptable. There's a dark down here. I need some dark down here. Need a dark down here a little bit. So I'm going to put some darks down there. Pull it in to this area. Looks much better. And then I'm going to also include some darks down here. I think that works. Yeah, I don't think that's too bad. This is kind of darkish here and so on, so I'm going to put a gray light maybe in there. And it appears like there's some rocks back there. And it's not so harsh line between the foliage and the rocks. I think maybe there could be a lighter rock right in here, as well as over this way. Okay, that's a wrap. Here it is, final painting. And come back again, subscribe, and give me a thumbs up. Thank you. Bye.